Now the next topic is packaging method and types of packages presented by Darshana More, Assistant Professor of Food Science, KKVA College of Horticulture, Nasik. Packaging means placing of commodity in a suitable container is called as packaging, and it is defined as a mean or a system in which fresh produce or processed produce will reach from production center to ultimate consumer in a safe and sound condition at an affordable price. Packaging fresh fruits and vegetables is one of the more important steps in the long and complicated journey from grower to consumer. In packaging, there are different types of materials available for the packing of different commodity. Main function of packaging is to assemble the produce into convenient units for handling. Second function, to protect the produce during storage and marketing. Some requirements of packaging material. The products cannot delay or prevent fresh fruits and vegetables from spoilage, and incorrect packaging can accelerate the spoilage. The packaging can serve to protect against contamination, damage, and most importantly against excess moisture loss. The packaging material protect fruits and vegetables from the pathogens. Then the size, weight, and shape limitation for the packaging material. Some requirements of packaging material. They must be non-toxic and compatible with the specific food. Sanitary protection. The packaging material do not produce gas or the odor. It should be protected from gas and odor. Light protection. It should be resistant to impact, and it's having transparency, appearance, and printability. It should be low cost. Then there are several types of packaging material available. First, natural materials, then wood pallets, wooden pallet, pallet bins, wire bounded crates, wooden crates and lugs, wooden basket and hampers, corrugated fiber board, pulp containers, pulp and mesh bags, plastic bags, shrink wrap, rigid plastic packages, plastic filled package boxes, vacuum packing, modified atmospheric packaging, control atmosphere, and grape guard. In the natural materials, the basket and other traditional containers are made from bamboo, rattan, saw, straw, palm leaves. Some disadvantages of natural materials because it is difficult to clean when the contaminated with decay organism. The lack of rigidity and bend out of shape when the stack for long distance transport. That means the natural material, it is not used for the long distance transportation. The low load badly because of their shape. They cause pressure damage when tightly filled. Then often have a sharp edges or splinters causing cut and punctures damage. Next types of material is wood pallets. The pallets are built as inexpensively as possible and discard after the single use. This is the features of wood pallets. Second, pallet bins. It is primarily used to move the produce from field to orchard and to the packaging house. This pallet bin are mostly used for field to orchard and to the packing house. Then wooden wire bounded crates are used for commodities that require hydrocooling. The wire bounded crates are sturdy, rigid, have very high stacking strength, and these are not generally acceptable for consumers packing house because of the difficulty in affixing suitable labels. Then wooden crates and lugs. The wooden crates and legs are once extensively used for the apple, stone fruits, potatoes, have been almost totally replaced by other types of container. The advances in materials handling have reduced their use to a few specialty items such as expensive tropical fruits. These are mostly used for the tropical fruits and apple, stone fruit and potatoes. Wooden basket and hampers. Wooden basket and hampers are used for wide variety of crops. It is durable and latest for efficient transport when empty. However, the cost, disposal problems and difficulty in efficient palatalization have severely limited their use to almost local grower markets when they may be reused many times. It is recyclable. It can be used, it may be reused. Then corrugated fiberboard. The corrugated fiberboard is manufactured in many different style and weights. Because of its relativity, low cost and versatility, it is the dominant produce container material and will probably remain so in the near future. In corrugated fiber boards, both temperature and relative humidity reduce the strength of fiber board containers. Unless the container is a specially treated, moisture absorbed from the surrounding air and contents can reduce the strength of container. It is mostly used for the cabbage, melons, potatoes, pumpkins and citrus have all been shipped successfully in these containers. The container cost per produce is a little as 1/4 of traditional size containers. Some bulk containers may be collapsed and reused. Then pulp containers. The pulp containers from recycled paper, made from recycled paper, pulp and starch binder are mainly used for small consumers' packages of fresh produce. The pulp containers are available in a large variety of shape and size and relatively inexpensive in standard size. The pulp container will be available in a different size, can absorb surface moisture from the product and are also biodegradable, made from recycled materials and recyclable. Paper and mesh bags. Paper and mesh bags. Consumer packs of potatoes, onions are about the only produce items now packed in a mesh bag. In paper mesh bags, bear, onion and potatoes mostly used for packing. In addition to its low cost, mesh has the advantages of inhibited airflow. Then good ventilation is particularly beneficial to onions. Supermarket produce manage like small mesh bags because they market attractive displays that stimulate purchase. It is a transparent and the product can be displayed. Then some disadvantages of paper and mesh bags. Large bags do not palatalize well and small bags do not efficiently fill the space inside the corrugated fiberboard containers. Bags do not offer protection from rough handling. Mesh bags provide little protection from light and contaminants. Then plastic bags. Polyethylene film are the predominant material for fruit and vegetable consumer packaging. Beside very low material cost, automated bagging machines further reduce the packaging cost. Film bags are clear, allowing for easy inspection of contents and readily accept high quality graphics. This is a low cost material and automatic bagging machine available that can be reduced the packing cost. Then shrink wrap. Shrink wrap is the recent advanced method of packaging. Shrink wrap with engineered plastic wrap can reduce the shrinkage and protect the produce from disease, reduce mechanical damage and provide a good surface for stick-on labels. The shrink wrapping mostly used for the potatoes, sweet potatoes, apple, onion and sweet corns. Then rigid plastic packages. Packages with top and bottom that are heat form from the one or two piece of plastics are known as clamshells. Clamshells are most often used with consumer packs of high value produce items like small fruits, berries and mushrooms. Then plastic filled boxes, usually made of polyvinyl chloride and polyethylene. They are durable, such can last maybe many years. They are designed in such way that they can nest inside each other when empty to facilitate transport and can nest inside each other when empty too. That means the transportation is easy when it is empty. Then controlled atmosphere. Controlled atmosphere refers to storage atmosphere that is different from the normal atmosphere in its composition, wherein the component Gases are precisely adjusted to specific concentration and maintained throughout the storage and distribution of the perishable produce. Controlled atmosphere, that means the atmosphere, it is in a controlled, that is in gas, a light humidity, then temperature, all in a control. Then controlled atmosphere release on the continuous measurement of the composition of storage atmosphere and the injection of the appropriate gases or the gases mixture into it, if and when needed. In controlled atmosphere, inject the gases, appropriate gases or the gases mixture in a limited quantity. Then hence the system requires sophisticated instrument to monitor the gases level and therefore practical only for the refrigerated bulk storage and shipment of commodities in a large container. It requires sophisticated instrument to monitor the gas level. Then tomatoes extensively low O2 and high CO2 prevents proper ripening even after removal of the fruit to air, and controlled atmosphere enhance the danger of chilling injury. In controlled atmosphere, CO2 level is low and O2 level is high. Then modified atmospheric packaging. Containing between 2 to 5% of oxygen and 3 to 3.8% of carbon dioxide have been shown to extend the shelf life of wide variety of fruits and vegetables. If the shelf life of commodity at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius is 1, by employing the modified atmospheric packaging, it will be doubled, whereas the refrigeration can extend the shelf life to 3, and the refrigeration combined with MAP can increase it to 4. That means the in MAP, the shelf life of the product can be increased as compared to ambient temperature as 4 days. Few types of films are routinely used for MAP. The important ones are polyvinyl chloride, polystyrene, polyethylene and polypropylene. These are the materials or the films are used in the modified atmospheric packaging. Modified atmospheric packaging are created inside the packages by the commodity itself or by active modification. The active modification involves creating a slight vacuum inside the packages and replacing it with a desired mixture of gases so as to establish a desired equilibrium modified atmosphere quickly composed to passively generated equilibrium atmospheric modified atmosphere. Another active modification technique is in the use of carbon dioxide or ethylene absorbance scavengers with the packages to prevent the buildup of particular gases within the packages. Some absorbents are used in atmospheric packaging to build up the particular gas within the packages. This method is called active packaging. Compounds like hydrated lime, activated charcoal, magnesium oxide are known to absorb carbon dioxide, while iron powder is known to absorb carbon dioxide. These are the absorbents. Potassium permanganate and phenyl methylene silicon can be used to absorb ethylene within the packages. The scavengers can be held in a small sachet within the post-harvest management and value addition of fruits and vegetables. The vacuum packaging. Vacuum packaging offers an extensive barriers against corrosion, oxidation, moisture, drying out, dirt, attraction of dust by electric harsh ultraviolet rays, mechanical damage, fungus growth and perishability. In vacuum packaging, the products to be packed in a put in a vacuum bags made of special hermetic fills that is then evacuated in a vacuum chamber and then sealed hermetically in order to provide a total barrier against moisture. If some of the product cannot bear the atmosphere pressure due to vacuum inside the package, then the package are flushed with inert gas like nitrogen and CO2 after evacuation. The vacuum packaging mostly used for against the barrier corrosion, oxidation, moisture, drying, dirt, etc. Then edible packaging. Then edible packaging material or the coating is simply defined as thin continuous layer of edible material formed on, placed on or between the foods or the food components. That is this, the packing material having property or to act as moisture and gases, mechanical strength and physical properties and resistant to microbial growth. The materials used for edible packaging includes lipid, proteins, polysaccharides and combination of any two and all of these. Many lipid compounds such as animal and vegetable fats, acetoglycerides have been used in the formulation of edible packaging for fresh fruit produce because of their excellent moisture barrier properties. The lipid coating on fresh fruits and vegetables reduce the weight loss due to dehydration during storage by 40 to 70%. Then grape guards. Grape guards are chemically treated paper sheets using active ingredients anhydrous sodium bisulfate. The grape guard is mostly used to extend the shelf life of grapes. Grape guards, especially chemically treated cellulosic antifungal paper that regulates the release of SO2 concentration at around 80 ppm for over 12 weeks at a time in increased individual carbon grapes. The function of grape guards to preserve the quality of grapes in store and transist by control of decay. Grape guards improve the quality by obtaining sturdy and bright unshriveled appearance of fruits. There are two types of grape guards available. First, quick release grape guards and dual release grape guards. In quick release grape guards, decay the development of 3 weeks at 0 degrees Celsius. And it can help for few days to control decay without refrigeration. In dual release grape guards, used for decay the retardation up to 12 weeks in a storage and transist with refrigeration facility. It is effectively only 0 degrees Celsius. That means the shelf life is increases in dual release grape guards at about 12 weeks. Corrugated fiberboard boxes, 3-ply with capacity 2 kg and 5 kg having dimension 20 by 25 by 20 by 12 cm is being used for packing. Different packaging materials like craft paper, butter paper and soft tissue papers for ventilation of grape guard is used. Then 6 to 9 gram of sodium bisulfate is good for grape guard contain. Then berry decays and berry drop was controlled by use of grape guards with containing 9 gram of sodium bisulfate. The grape guards containing sodium bisulfate extend the shelf life of Thompson seedless, Anabishai, Dilkush and Sharad seedless 14, 8, 8 and 16 respectively at an ambient temperature and up to 75 and 85 days respectively under the cold storage. The grape guard mostly used for to extend the shelf life of grapes. Then the cushioning materials. The function of cushioning material is to fix the commodity inside the packaging and prevent them from mixing out in a relation to each other and the packages itself when there is a vibration or the impact. The cushioning material is used or the function of cushioning material to protect the produce in the packaging. Some cushioning materials can also provide packages with traditional stacking strength. There are different types of cushioning materials are available like paper wrapping, fiber board, single or double wall, molded paper pulp trays, molded foam, polystyrene trays, molded plastic trays, foam, plastic sheets, plastic liners or the bags, control or modified atmospheric pack. Thank you. The some questions related to packaging material. First, define the packaging. Second, the function. What is the function of packaging? And write down the different material of packaging. Enlist the types of materials and write down the advanced methods of packaging.